성경 우리 66권을 보면서 하나님의 응답을 잘 정리해야 되겠습니다.
As we read through the 66 books of the Bible, we must organize very well the word of God.
듣는 것이 아니고 여러분 말씀을 확인하셔야 됩니다.
Don't just listen to a sermon, but confirm the word of God.
오늘 2부는 다윗의 생애에 관한다.
For this second worship, we will talk about David's life.
이렇게 많은 사람들이 이렇게 착각을 하고 있습니다.
So many people misunderstand.
어떤 착각을 합니까?
What kind of misunderstanding do they have?
이렇게 굉장히 인맥이 있어야 된다라고 생각합니다.
People believe that they need good networks.
언론 보면 맞는 말 같은데 인맥이 아니고 인맥을 통해서 이걸 알게 되니까요. 우리가 뭘 정보를 제대로 알면 사실 필요 없거든요.
And many people feel that if you have a good network of people, you're going to get a lot of information. And that is true to some point.
이거는 사실을 말하는 건데 사실을 잘 모르고 인맥 중심하면 망합니다.
And information is talking about the facts. But if you are working hard to get good networks, but you're not getting the facts, that'll be a problem.
이거 모르면서 이거 있으면 사고 나요.
The reason why there are so many accidents out in the world is because people lack the facts. They don't have the right information, but they're only focusing on people and networks. That's how King Saul was.
하는 인맥을 만들어 있으면은 자기 힘이 있을 거라고 생각을 했어요.
He thought that if he knew a lot of people and if he knew the right people, he would have a lot of power.
다윗은 전혀 그렇게 생각하지 않았습니다.
But David had not. He did not think of that at all.
정말로 영적인 사실과 많은 걸 알고 있었습니다.
But David understood the spiritual facts and he knew many things.
그래 대부분 사람들은 그렇게 착각을 합니다.
But so many people live inside of this kind of misunderstanding.
권력을 갖고 있으면 된다라고 합니다.
And they also believe that they also need to possess some kind of great power. And at first glance, it does look like it's true, but it's not.
하나님이 위에서 내리는 이 권세가 굉장히 중요합니다.
The authority that God gives from above, from heaven, is so very important.
그래서 많은 사람들이 싸워서 이긴다고 생각합니다.
Also, many people feel that you need to have a lot of fights with people and win. That's how King Saul was. That's why he thought he needed to kill King David or kill David.
착각을 하기 쉽죠.
It's very easy to misunderstand this way.
그러나 다윗은 그렇게 하지 않았습니다.
But David was not like that.
싸움 대상을 잘 알고 있었습니다.
David knew the right opponent.
블레셋하고는 용감하게 싸웠습니다, 다윗이.
David was very bold when he fought with the Philistines.
사울 왕하고는 싸우지 않기 위해서 피했습니다.
But David did not fight with King Saul, but instead ran away from him.
그렇게 많은 착각을 합니다.
In this manner, so many people misunderstand.
오늘 다윗의 생애를 보면서 가장 중요한 것을 붙잡아야 돼요.
As we look through the life of David, let's hold on to the most important things.
사무엘상 16장 13절과 사무엘상 16장 23절입니다.
1 Samuel chapter 16 verse 13 and 1 Samuel 16 verse 23.
이게 문제가 아니고 다윗은 중요한 걸 알고 있었어요.
For David, these other things were not important to him, but these verses, that's what was important.
이날 이후로 여호와의 신이 다윗에게 충만하니라.
If you look in verse 13 of chapter 16, it says, from that day on, the spirit of the Lord came upon David in power.
다윗에게 크게 감동되니라.
It says that the spirit of the Lord came upon David in power.
23절은 사울 왕에게 있던 악신이 떠나가는 장면입니다.
And then if you look in chapter 16:23, it talks about evil spirits oppressing King Saul.
때부터 다윗은
leaving him
잘 알고 있었습니다.
Because of David's praise. And David knew these things very well since he was young. It's when he was very young he knew this.
이것밖에 모르는 사울 왕은 이길 수가 없어요.
And Saul, who knew only these physical things, he could not overcome David.
속이 있습니다. 목사님 현장 가보면 어렵다는 게 그렇게 생각하기 쉽습니다.
So many people say, Pastor, you just don't understand. You don't know the world. And I'm sure it's easy to think that way.
사업이 얼마나 막 그렇게 그게 틀린 말이 아니란 말이에요.
That's not incorrect to talk about Saul and all his power.
그러나 다윗은 더 중요한 걸 알고 있었어요.
But David knew something that was much more important.
오늘 여러분이 다윗의 응답인 지금도 우리 나타날 증거이기 때문에 굳게 잘 붙잡으셔야 됩니다.
You need to hold on to this answer of David. It's an evidence for us today. You must grab hold of it firmly.
다윗은 첫째로 세상을 바르게 알고 있었습니다.
As we go into the main theme, the first point is this. David knew the world correctly.
세상을 딱 바르게 알고 있었어요.
He understood things of the world correctly.
대부분 99% 사람이 사울 왕처럼 살아가고 있다는 걸 알았어요.
He understood that most people, 99% of the people, live like King Saul.
절대 속지 말아야 됩니다.
So you two must never be deceived.
이 지금 평생 동안을 시기하고 질투하고 그렇게 살 수밖에 없잖아요. 그렇게 된 겁니다.
For King Saul, he had no choice but to live in envy and jealousy for his entire life. He had no choice.
사울 왕과 그 따르는 사람들은 뭐 했는고 하니까 자리 다툼하고 살았어요.
What did he do for his entire life? All he did was fight over positions.
그래서 사무엘상 18장 7절 8절에 보면 나오잖아요.
You can see evidence of that in 1 Samuel chapter 18, verse 7 to 8. What does it say?
사울 왕이 이긴 자가 천이라면 다윗이 이긴 자가 만이다.
The women were singing, Saul has slain his thousands and David his tens of thousands.
사울 왕은 천천이요, 다윗은 만만이다.
Say, Saul has killed thousands, but David tens of thousands.
이런 말을 쓰는 사람도 문제지만 그거 쓰니까 사울 왕이 그거 보고 사람이 이상하게 된 거요.
Of course, those who are singing those words, it's a bit strange, but for Saul who heard it, he could not handle this.
사울에게 뺏기, 다윗에게 뺏기겠구나.
So he thought that his position as king would be stolen by David.
이거는 사울 왕만 그런 게 아니고 대부분 사람들이 그렇게 살고 있다는 걸 다윗은 정확하게 본 겁니다.
And David accurately knew and was able to see that not only King Saul was like this, but most people.
그래서 여러분들이 다윗이 받은 것처럼 중요한 언약을 세상을 바르게 알고 있는 다윗이었다.
David, you should be just like him, where he accurately understood that the world, he understood accurately what the world is about.
이런 부분에 흔들리질 않았어요.
He knew that ever since he was young. That's why he wasn't shaken by all these other things.
드디어 성경이 여러 군데 있습니다.
We can see this in several places in the Bible.
특히 사무엘상 16장 23절 보니까 사울 왕이 이래서 악신에게 잡혀버린 거예요.
Especially in that passage of 1 Samuel 16:23, we see how King Saul was possessed
세상입니다.
by an evil spirit. This is the world.
이 정도가 아닙니다.
But it's not the end of it.
사무엘상 28장 3절 7절에 보면 사울 왕이 뭐 하는 줄 압니까?
Do you know what Saul does in chapter 28, verse 3 to 7?
저 엔돌 여인에게 점치러 갑니다.
He actually goes to get help from a sorcerer in the place of in Endor.
아니, 하나님을 믿는 왕이 이제 이 영적 문제 오니까요. 점쟁이 사람을 점친다니까 이런 식으로까지 됐잖아요.
He was a king who believed in God, but he came to this place spiritually where he had to get help from a fortune teller. For King Saul, his problems were just were not ending. What else happened to him? What happened to him?
계속 어려움 나고 전쟁이 납니다.
He continued to face hardship and then finally
a war. 사무엘상 31장 1절 13절에 보면 사무엘은 이 사울 왕은 전쟁 만나서 결국은 자살합니다.
In chapter 31, verse 1 to 13, Saul meets with a war with the Philistines and eventually kills himself.
마지막입니다.
That was the end of his life.
다윗은 이걸 전혀 두려워하지 않았습니다.
And for David, he was not afraid of this at all.
그런데요, 세상 사람들은 이걸 그렇게 두려워해요.
How is it that the people of the world are so afraid
여러분,
of these
다윗은
things?
사울 왕에 대한 모든 것을 전혀 두려워하지 않았어요.
David was not afraid, even a little. For what was happening with him.
이 사울 왕이 그렇게도 하는 일이 하나밖에 없어 다윗 죽이는 겁니다.
For King Saul, his only goal in life was to kill David.
왜 그렇습니까?
Do you know why?
내가 왕이 돼야지 네가 왕이 되면 안 돼.
I have to be the king. You shall never be the king.
우리 아들이 왕이 돼야지 네가 왕이 되면 안 돼.
And my son should be the next king. You will never be the king.
그것만 사울 왕의 꿈이고 주제였습니다.
For King Saul, that was his dream. That was his main focus.
밤낮 없이 시기 생기고 질투 생기고 그것밖에 없는 거요.
That is why day and night he's filled with envy and jealousy. That's it.
더 중요한 거는 성경 전체 읽어보면 사울 왕이 그렇다 보니까 그런 신하들만 붙었어요.
What's really amazing is because King Saul was like that. If you look throughout the history, only those kinds of officials would arise.
다윗을 그냥 두면 안 된다.
And that's why they bother King Saul even more, saying, Oh, you can't leave David alone.
왕을 죽이러 올 거다 말이야.
He's going to come and kill you.
아, 이런 거짓말 자꾸 하는 게 사울 왕이 더 미치는 거예요.
And these officials would lie to him, so he would go even more crazy.
이게 세상입니다.
This is the world.
여러분들 속지 마시고 어려움 와도 전혀 흔들리지 마시고 당당히 언약 붙잡고 하나님의 말씀 따라가라.
Don't be afraid. Don't be deceived. But firmly, boldly grab hold of the covenant.
약간만 속지 않으면 다 볼 건데 우리는 거의 흔들리죠.
We don't need to be deceived at all. The answers will come, but most of us just shake.
그러니까 상상치도 않은 일이 벌어져요.
Then you can see something unimaginable took place. A war broke out.
뭐 기다린 겁니까? 전쟁이 터진 거예요.
Did you think that he waited for it? A war just simply started.
전쟁이 터지니까 사울 왕이 이제 직접 말 타고 전쟁터에 나간 겁니다.
Because of the war, Saul had to go into the battlefield himself.
위급하게 되니까 나간 거죠.
He had to go out because Israel was in a very dire situation.
그래서 이제 막 싸움을 하는데 전쟁 중에서 일어난 일이요.
In the middle of the battle, this is what happened.
저 블레셋 군대가 쏜 화살이 사울 왕 가슴에 꽂힌 거예요.
One of the arrows that was flying around fell into Saul's body.
근데 이제 살 길이 없잖아요.
Now there was no way for him to survive.
화살 꽂힌 거를 이게 부러뜨린 겁니다.
Well, the arrow that had went into his body, he tried to pull it out, it broke. It didn't come out, but it broke.
근데 사울 왕이 이렇게 말을 합니다.
So then Saul says this.
내가 이스라엘 왕이다.
I am the king of Israel.
어떻게 블레셋 족속의 쫄개에게 죽을 수 있냐?
How can I die by the hand of the soldier of the Philistines?
쫄개에게 내가 죽을 수는 없다.
That was his pride speaking. I will not die by the hand of the Philistines.
이래가지고는 칼을 가지고 부하를 뭐 준단 말이에요. 찌르라는 거예요.
So he takes his sword and he tells his armor bearer to run it through him.
내가 저런 쫄병들 손에 죽을 수 없으니까 나를 찌르라 이렇게는.
He says, I will not let these uncircumcised fellows come and run me through it and abuse me.
아무리 왕의 명령이지만은 그 부하가 말이요, 그 칼질을 용기가 안 나는 거요.
And even though he must obey orders, the armor bearer was so terrified he could not obey those orders.
칼 뺏어가지고 자기가 찔러 엎어가지고.
So Saul had to take his own sword, fell upon it, and died.
그리고 그게 사울 왕의 마지막이었어요.
That was the very last day of Saul.
블레셋 군대가 달려들하고 사울 왕 목 잘라가 가지고 와버려.
Then the Philistines came and saw his dead body. They cut off his head and took it.
인생 참으로 비참하게 끝난 겁니다.
His life ended in such a pathetic way.
평생을 악신들려 살다가 비참하게 끝나가.
His entire life he lived being afflicted, oppressed by evil spirits, and then he died in this very, very pathetic way.
왕이었습니다.
Whoever it was. Anybody who saw him would see how glamorous 세상입니다. Of a king he was. But this is the world.
다윗은 전혀 흔들리지 않았어요.
David did not tremble or shake at all in the face of the world. Especially you remnants need to remember this.
제가 그 여러분들 몇 번 얘기했습니다만은 제가 공부할 때요. 우선 배경도 없는 것 같고 가난한 것 같고 이렇더라니까요.
I said this many times, but as a student myself, I felt like I didn't have very much background, no strength.
사는 게 어렵지 않겠나 이런 생각이 들더라니까요.
I started to think how difficult my life would be in the future.
왜냐면 다들 보니까 뭐 배경도 있는 것 같고 뭐 다 이래요. 나는 왜 이렇지 이런 생각이 들더라니까요.
I looked at other people around me and I thought they have some thing to themselves. They have a background, but I didn't feel like I had anything.
나는 못 하잖아요.
I thought, what's wrong with my life? People get to do whatever they want, but I couldn't.
우리는 이럴 때 헷갈립니다.
It's usually during this time we get these times we get confused.
하나님이 좋은 생각을 주셨어요.
But the Lord gave me a good thought.
지금 내게 돈이 필요한 거 아니다.
What I need right now is not money.
지금 내가 뭔가를 성취하는 성공자가 되는 것이 아니다.
And what I need to do is not become a person of success right now.
지금 내가 뭘 많이 가지고 배경 가지고 출세하는 게 아니다.
It's not about me trying to succeed and excel with all my great backgrounds.
원하시는 것을 보아야 된다.
I need to see what God wants.
이때.
It was at this time.
나는 현장으로 가야 된다.
I realized that I need to go into the field.
현장 간 거요.
So I went into the field.
정말로 정말로 주의 은혜요. 그 현장이 지금도 응답으로 오고 있어요.
It really, really, truly was the grace of God. And that field back then is still yielding, giving me great answers today.
하나님의 것을 본 다윗입니다.
And the second point is David who has seen the things of God. Don't be deceived. David could have been deceived.
하나님의 백성은 속지 않는 겁니다.
But the people of God are not deceived.
누구에게 말입니까?
By who?
세상에게 속지 않는 겁니다.
They are not deceived by the things of the world.
하나님의 사람은 자신에게 속지 않는 겁니다.
And a person of God will not be deceived by themselves.
육신에게 속지 않는 겁니다.
What that means is, well, they will not be deceived by flesh, by physical things. And the people of God will not be deceived by Satan.
세상에게 속습니다.
But we are always being deceived by the world, by ourselves.
결국은 사단에게 속.
But in the end, we are being deceived by Satan.
그럼 인간의 실패가 뭐냐? 사단에게 속은 거 아닙니까?
What is the failure of mankind? We were deceived by Satan. There is no need for that now.
거기에서 하나님의 축복을 찾는 겁니다.
If I lack something, then I try to find the plan of God there.
그런데 이 다윗은요, 절대 속지 않은 하나님의 것을 봤어요.
David was not deceived at all. He was able to see the things of God.
이래가지고 다윗의 소년 시절을 보세요.
Let's look at David's childhood.
놓치지 말아야 될 부분입니다.
This is something we should not lose hold of.
여기 중요한 말 많이 나옵니다만 두 가지를 봐야 돼요.
Very important things are written in Psalm 78, 70-72. Let's look at two things. First is skillful hands and integrity of heart. What is that?
하나님을 아는 믿음과 실력을.
It's about believing in God, faith to believe in God and your skill.
하나님을 아는 영성과 지성을.
So it's about the spirituality of knowing God as well as intellect. So it's having that.
더 중요한 거는 여기서 다윗은 시도 썼습니다.
And what's very important also is in this passage, you can see that he wrote so many poems. Don't lose hold of the word of God, like I mentioned in the first worship.
다윗은 아침에 일어나서 어른 때부터 내려오는 하나님의 말씀을 상고했어요.
Ever since David was a young child, he would meditate in the early morning with the words that was passed down, that were passed down from his ancestors, and he would pray. He wrote about 73 poems. And what's most important is what is hidden in this passage.
시편 78편을 보면 분명히 기록하기를 왕으로 기록했다 그랬어요.
Now, what we can see what David wrote as a child was that God was training him and raising him up as a king.
중요하죠.
That's very important.
목동으로 있는데 왕으로 기록했다.
Even though he was a shepherd, he was raising up a king.
드디어 다윗에게 청소년 시절이 옵니다.
And finally we see David reaching adolescence.
청소년 시절에서 두 가지를 만나게 됩니다.
And during this time in his life we can see two things.
뭡니까?
What are they?
드디어 가지고 있었던 그 축복이 성취되죠.
The covenant, the blessing that was given
말합니다.
to him was now being fulfilled.
사무엘이 와서는 기름 부어주고 너는 이스라엘의 왕이 될 것이다.
Samuel came to him and anointed him, telling him he would be the king of Israel.
이날 이후로 다윗에게 다윗 여호와의 신에 크게 감동되니라.
And if you look at this passage of 1 Samuel 16, 1-13, from that day on, the Spirit of the Lord came upon David in power.
만나게 되는 겁니다.
Then in the next chapter, 1 Samuel 17, he meets Goliath. David already knew he would be the king.
골리앗 만나 피한 게 아닙니다.
He wasn't trying to run away from Goliath.
여러분 이 시절에 골리앗을 담대히 없애는 놀라운 역사가 일어났습니다.
As you know very well, this passage records the amazing work of how he broke down Goliath in one shot. And this is what David said.
여호와께서 나와 함께 하셨으므로 골리앗과 함께 싸울 때 하나님 함께 하실 것이라고 얘기했었어요.
David said, just as the Lord God was with me until now, he will be with me so I can overcome Goliath. And it's the same thing in this passage.
다윗은 영적인 힘만 있을 뿐만 아니라 실제 골리앗을 이길 힘이 있었어요. 기술이 있었습니다.
David not only had the spiritual power to overcome Goliath, but he also had the skill to do it.
특히 우리 렘넌트들은 이런 축복을 가지고 출발해야 돼요.
Especially you as remnants must begin everything with this.
렘넌트 때 조금만 영성을 기르면 이 부분을 알게 되면 여러분은 굉장한 것 보게 됩니다.
If you can develop your spirituality during your childhood, during your youth, and just remember these things, amazing things will happen.
어릴 때 이 사실을 아는 사람에게는 세상 두렵지 않습니다.
As a child, if you learn about these spiritual things, you will not be afraid of the world.
하나님의 말씀 보고 이 부분을 알게 되면은 하나님의 것을 보게 됩니다.
If you know the things, if you really know the spiritual things and pray just a little bit, God will reveal to you the things of God.
하나님을 아는 믿음 기도 있었습니다만은 이 돌 던지는 기술도 있었어요.
So David did have prayer and he had faith to believe in God, but he also had the skill of slinging rocks.
자신만만하게 나갔어요.
He went out in confidence.
그렇죠. 망설임 없이 자신만만하게 나갔어요.
He had no hesitation. He went out 왜냐? In confidence.
사자도 이겼는데요.
Why? Because he overcame a lion.
여러분, 사자가 뭐 빠릅니까? 그 사자를 그냥 이긴 게 아니요. 돌 던져서 급소를 때려서 이긴 거예요.
Do you think he just simply threw a rock at the lion? No. While it was in motion, he was able to sling that rock and hit him on the head.
왕 앞에 얘기했잖아요.
He said that before the king.
여호와께서는 나를 사자와 곰에게서 건져 주셨습니다.
The Lord has rescued me from the paws of the lion and bear.
하나님을 모욕하는 자 손에서 나를 건지실 줄 믿습니다.
And I believe that the Lord God will rescue me from the hands of this uncircumcised man.
안대하죠.
He was so bold.
여러분이 이 믿음을 가져야 될 축복의 사람이다.
You are the people of blessing who can receive this answer.
어려움이 올 때는 웃고 기다리세요.
When hardships come, just simply wait and smile.
예, 이게 애탈 필요도 없습니다.
There's no need to be so frustrated.
시를 지어가면서 기다렸다니까.
For David, he waited while writing poems. That's amazing, right?
이 다윗의 모습을 감아 보면요. 보통 웃기는 사람이 아니에요.
I look carefully at the life of David and I think he's just not your average individual.
그 죽음 위기를 우리 같으면 얼마나 긴장된다. 장난하듯이 넘었었어요.
In the face of death even, he was able to just transcend that so easily like it was just a play thing.
그 증거 두 개 있습니다.
And there's evidence 뭡니까? Of that. In two places.
굴에 숨어 있는데 그 굴 속에 사울 왕이 다윗 잡으러 다니다가 잠자러 들어간 거예요.
At one time, David was hiding inside of a cave, and in that very cave, King Saul came in to rest.
왜 밖에서 이게 밝은 것보다 안에 들어가면 안 보이잖아요. 안 보이니까 그냥 옆에 누운 거란 말이에요.
As you're going into a dark place, you can't really see. And Saul did not see that David was there. He lied down right next to him. Of course, David would be so shocked to see this.
아니면, 뭐 전화하든지 아버지 하든지 뭐 수가 났을 거 아니요.
And perhaps being shocked like that, he would call him father or oh my king.
요 다윗이 얼마나 웃기냐. 왕 옆에 가고요 칼 가지고 옷자락 잘랐잖아요.
David was so funny. What did he do? He cut off a piece of his robe while he was sleeping.
그러고 딱 하고 있다가 이래서 나갈 때 불렀다니까요.
And after waiting for him to wake up, King Saul got up and left the cave, 아니, and then David called him.
하니까 그때서야 뭐라고 불렀습니까?
And as King Saul was leaving, David called him, what?
아니, 아버지라고 불렀단 말이에요.
He says, my father.
이 사울 아버지 다윗 목소리거든요. 돌아보니 다윗이 있는 거예요.
He hears David's voice and he turns around and it was David.
이거 보여줬잖아요.
And he showed him the piece that he cut off.
다윗이 이걸 웃긴 사람입니다. 이렇게.
David is funny in that way.
그 뭐냐 이게.
King Saul says, what is that?
아버지의 옷이다. 옷.
This is the piece of your robe that I cut off.
내가 아버지를 죽이는 것 죽인다 그 거짓말이다 죽이거든 벌써 죽이지 않았냐?
People who say that I want to kill you, that's a lie. I could have killed you if I wanted.
이 안에 들어왔을 때 죽일 수 있는데 내가 이렇게까지 했는데 그 거짓말이다.
You came into the cave where I was. I could have killed you, but I don't want to kill you. That's why I cut off this piece.
그러니까
so please believe me.
감동 잘 맞는 사울 왕이 내 아들아 내가 잘못했다면서 막 또 회개하잖아요.
King Saul, he's easily moved. He repents. He says, "Okay, I'm very sorry." You're my son.
그리고 말합니다. 하나님이 너를 축복하실 거다.
And then he even said, God will bless you, my son.
악신 들린 사람 그래서 왔다 갔다 잘해요.
People who are demon-possessed actually go back and forth. As soon as he leaves David, he goes back again to his old ways.
그리고 또 잡으러 나옵니다.
And then he goes out and chases him again.
군대 끌고 다윗 잡으러 죽이나 또 나왔다니까.
With a whole entire army, he comes out to find David again.
군인들 쫙 대기시켜 놓고 왕이 이제 사흘 이 다윗 찾는 거요.
He would take his whole army and search throughout the mountains to find David.
밤이 왔다.
But then it was one night.
좀 자고 이제 일어나야 될 거 아니요.
When it's night, the soldiers and the king would sleep and then go and search again in the morning. See how funny David is in this story.
사울 왕을 지키는 경호 있을 거 아니요. 이 경호 옆에 딱 지키고 있단 말이요.
You know that King Saul had bodyguards and soldiers protecting him.
요 친구가 잠깐 잠들은 거요.
But throughout the night, this soldier fell asleep.
그 사이에 뭐가 좁니까? 물병하고 칼하고 훔쳐오잖아요.
But during that time when his soldiers were sleeping, David steals his jug of water and his spear.
그런 게 사울 왕 또 하나님 축복하시고.
Then King Saul says again, "Oh my son, God is going to bless you."
나는 그걸 가만 보면서요, 이 다윗이 정말로 여유 있는 사람이다.
But as I look at these passages and David's behavior, I see that he has so much leisure.
다윗은 정말로 언약 가지고 있는 사람이다.
He really was a man who held to the covenant.
정말 이 사람은 기도의 사람이란 거, 기도가 이토록 큰 영적인 축복인 줄 사람들은 모르고 있을 것이다.
And he really was a man of prayer. So many people, I'm sure, do not know this power of prayer.
담대히 얘기하잖아요.
Standing before Goliath, David said boldly,
나는 네가 모욕하는 만군의 여호와 이름으로 네게 왔다.
I come before you in the name of the Lord God Almighty.
대단하지요.
Whom you are cursing.
네 목을 내 손에 붙이셨느니.
He's truly amazing, and he says, "The Lord will hand your life into my hands."
전 세계에 구원이 칼에 있지 않음을 하나님의 손에 있음을 증명하겠다.
And to the entire world, I will testify that the battle is not in the hands of the sword, but in God's hands.
이때가 청소년 때입니다.
That's so amazing, right? Do you know how old he was? He was just a teenager.
그리고 골리앗이 이기고 돌아오잖아요.
He wins Goliath and he comes home.
그때부터 이제는 다윗의 청년 시절에는 고난이 계속됩니다.
Later on, he becomes an adult. And then this is the beginning of his suffering.
가지고 군인을 풀어서 계속 죽이려고.
King Saul had his whole entire army chasing after David and making him suffer so much.
다윗의 고백입니다.
But David confesses in Psalm 23 verse 1.
여호와가 나의 목자시기 때문에 나는 부족함이 없다.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want.
한국말로 여러 가지 해석돼 있는데 정확하게 말하면 그래요. 여호와가 나의 목자시기 때문에 나는 결핍함이 전혀 없다.
I'm sure many people have different interpretations, but what I think it means is the Lord is my shepherd, and I will not lose sleep over anything.
더 필요한 것이 없다.
The Lord is my shepherd, therefore I need nothing else.
그 말입니다.
That's what he is saying.
대단하지요.
That's amazing, right?
내가 사망의 음침한 골짜기 다닐지라도 그 말은 다녔다는 말이에요.
Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, why did he write that? He wrote that because he himself went through it.
두려워하지 않는다.
And he said, I will fear no evil.
막대기가 나를 아리하시나이다.
I am not afraid of those things because your rod and your staff, they comfort me.
고백입니다.
Those are the confessions of David.
여러분이 이런 축복 받고 우리 렘넌트들이 받을 수 있는 자격이 있다 그 말이요.
May you receive these blessings. And I want to say to the remnants, you also have the eligibility to receive these blessings.
드디어 다윗은 임금이 된 겁니다.
Finally, David becomes a king.
그때에 사무엘 대제사장에 들었던 거 준비합니다.
What he did at this time was he started to make preparations. What he heard from God, from Prophet Samuel, and it was the preparation of the temple.
우리가 마음속에 오늘 결심해야 됩니다. 이 정도 축복을 받아야 된다.
And I want you to make 그렇죠. this resolution in your heart. You too should be blessed in this manner, as 2 Chronicles chapter 29.
우리가 성전을 지어 사람 살릴 만큼 하나님의 언약 가진 축복 받아야 된다.
Now answers come according to how well our spiritual state is organized. So if you receive this kind of blessing, God will save the entire world. God gave this blessing to David.
그렇게 해서 솔로몬에게 그랬죠.
And then he passed it on to Solomon.
자, 그로 끝난 게 아닙니다.
But that was not the end of it.
뭐든지 바르게 알아야 되죠.
In anything that you do, you have to know about it correctly.
사명을 바르게 본 다윗입니다.
David was a man who was accurately able to see his commission.
실수도 있었어요. 그렇죠?
Now David did make mistakes too.
실수도 있었는데 그 이 바세바를 데리고 오기 위해서 우리아를 죽게 하고는 실수 있었잖아요.
He did make a mistake where he had to kill somebody so that he could take Bathsheba as his own wife.
나단 선지자가 와가지고 다윗에게 얘기하잖아요.
And as you know well, Nathan the prophet came to speak to David.
그때 다윗은 그 얘기를 듣고 막바로 회개합니다.
David, after hearing the words of the prophet, he repented right away.
사람들 얘기하면 거의 거짓말하잖아요. 다윗은 그 자리에서 회개합니다.
Many people they're not willing to admit the wrong that they have done, but for him he confessed it. Right away, he repented. He's amazing.
왕이 나단 선지자가 얘기할 때도 이게 왕이니까 바로 못하잖아요. 말을 비비 꼬아가지고 이렇게 얘기합니다.
When Nathan came to see him, even though he's the prophet, he couldn't just directly attack the king, so he had to tell a story.
다윗에게 약점이 없었던 건 아니지만은 다윗은 더 중요한 걸 가지고 있었어요.
And David also knew that he himself was not perfect,
뭡니까?
But he received, or he really knew something most important.
여기에 대해서 굉장한 기도를 했습니다.
For this, he prayed so much, the Ark of the Covenant.
뭐라고 기도했습니까?
What do you think he prayed for?
나는 좋은데 잠을 자고 있는데 언약궤는 바람 부는데 있다.
I sleep in a very comfortable place in the palace, but the Ark of the Covenant is a place where the wind blows. You know, there are not many people who even think
그렇잖아요.
This way, right?
아니, 뭐,
so many people, they just care about living well by
아니,
themselves.
나는 뭐 외국 가봐도 그렇다니까요. 뭐, 교회당은 없는데 교인들 싹 다 집 다 있어요. 뭐 번쩍번쩍 그것도 뭐 엄청 수영장도 있고 뭐 대단하더라니까요.
I go overseas and I notice that there are no actual church buildings, but the believers have very nice houses and very nice cars. They take care of themselves very well.
뭐 교회당은 없어.
But there's no church building.
빌리스잖아요.
They actually just have to rent it.
뭐 그런 상황인데 어린이 다윗은 달랐어요.
That was a situation. But David was different.
나는 왕궁에서 잠을 자는데 언약궤는 바람 부는 데 있으니까 잠을 잘 수가 없다.
I am sleeping in the palace, but the temple or the Ark of the Covenant is inside of a tent, and I don't feel good about that. I will not sleep.
성전을 짓자고 호소한 거요.
So that is why he requested if he could create or build a temple.
그러니까 전 백성이 참여가 차고 넘쳤다.
And all of the nation came into agreement with him, and the offerings overflowed. And that's when we can see his confession.
뭐라고 합니까?
What did he say?
차고 넘치도록 들어왔는데 이것은 우리가 하나님께 헌금한 것이 아니다.
The offering came in and overflowed. And yet David said, these are not from us.
하나님이 우리에게 주신 것으로 했을 뿐이다.
All we could do is give back what the Lord has given us.
이것은 하나님의 은혜요. 하나님이 주신 것으로 했다.
These are all yours, O God, and we can only give this offering with what you have given to us first. He truly was a remarkable man.
다윗을 쓰실 수밖에 없는 그릇이 준비된 거죠.
And that is why we see that David's vessel was prepared, so God had no choice but to use him.
자, 여러분들은 이걸 보고 다윗이 뭘 했냐 하는 겁니다.
With this, how can we describe the things that he's done? Really grab hold of this.
저는 제일 걱정되는 사람이 농구하니까요. 무차별로 일 열심히 하는 사람 제일 걱정됩니다.
What I'm so scared of or what I'm worried about are those people who don't have much thought but they just go ahead and do the work. They're diligent. They just get involved in everything.
별로 성공한 예가 없습니다.
And I haven't seen many successful people who do that.
이게 우리 올해 주제입니다. 다윗은 하나님의 절대 목표를 이루었어요.
This was also the New Year's theme message for us for this year. David really knew God's absolute goal.
다윗은 하나님의 뜻을 이루는 절대 사명 가졌어요.
David also had God's absolute mission whereby he would fulfill God's covenant. And I hope that you will receive this blessing.
정말로 원하시는 곳에 헌신했어요.
And also you should give yourself and serve the Lord in the place where he truly desires. If you can, then you will receive answers. You have to remember this.
그래서 이러다 보니까 특징이 있어요.
Now we can also see a special characteristic.
다윗이 걸어간 길의 특징이 여러분에게 똑같이 올 건데 뭡니까?
The answers that came in David's lifetime, they can also be yours. What are they?
가는 곳에 미리 응답하셨어요.
For David, God blessed him ahead of time wherever he went.
다윗은 가는 곳에 미리 성공했어요.
For David, everywhere he went, he had success ahead of
그러니까
time.
그러니까 말이 되는 거요.
And then we can make sense of this.
여호와가 나의 목자시기 때문에 나는 아무런 부족함이 없다.
The Lord is my shepherd, so there is nothing that I lack.
자신 있게 말했어요.
He was so confident about that.
그렇잖아요.
Don't you think?
여러분이 그런 축복 누려야 되는 겁니다. 자신 있게 말할 수 있어야 돼요.
You should be able to enjoy this blessing too and be confident to speak of it. When?
저 서울역의 거지가 여호와는 나의 목자시니 내가 안 부족함이 없더라 뭐 다른 사람이 비웃거든요. 그렇잖아요.
If one of the homeless people sitting in front of the station said Jesus the Christ has every problem, people might look down on him.
골리앗을 이긴 천하의 장군 다윗이 고백하기를 여호와가 나의 목자시기 때문에 나는 어디를 가도 부족함이 없다.
But David, who broke down Goliath, the enemy of Israel, he said, "The Lord is my shepherd, and I don't lack a thing."
말이 되는 거요.
That made sense coming from
앞으로
David.
앞으로 하나님께서 주신 축복으로 여러분의 후대들이 그렇게 말할 수 있도록.
Let's pray that through your life, your future generations, your children will be able to also say that.
불신자가 여러분을 쳐다보고. 하나님이 당신과 함께 하시는구나.
In your life, for the rest of your life, pray that other non-believers could look at you and say, Yes, God is with you. Make it so that they can say that.
항복하고 여호와께서 너와 함께 하시는구나.
And those evil people, maybe the non-believers, let them be able to confess it and see that God is with you.
Why?
Because King Saul also saw that. He knew that God was with David.
어쩔 수 없이 축복했어요. 여호와께서 너와 함께 하실 것이다.
And Saul had no choice but to bless David by saying, "The Lord will bless you, David."
이런 축복입니다. 오늘 사무엘의 말씀 운동이라든지 다윗의 생에 나는 역사들이 굉장히 중요합니다.
The message that I shared earlier about the word movement and being centered on the word.
자, 요약합시다.
On the first message of Samuel,
되니까.
You should also remember that, and I'll repeat it so you don't lose hold.
곁에 누운 사무엘.
Samuel slept next to the Ark of the Covenant. That's very important.
어릴 때 이 사실을 본 다윗.
And David, who was able to see these spiritual facts since he was young, that's going to be the solution to everything.
하나님의 말씀이 여러분에게 성취되는 데는 막을 자가 없어요.
Nobody can block the word of God that will be fulfilled inside of you.
여러분이 없다고 해도 이 두 개는 있습니다.
You might say, I don't have anything, but you do have these two things. We are not being controlled by evil spirits, but we are being guided by the Holy Spirit.
이 붙잡고 이번 주간 기도하시기를 주님의 이름으로 축복합니다.
I bless you in the name of the Lord that you can really
기도하겠습니다.
hold on to this prayer for the rest of the week.
Let's 새로운 pray. 힘을 주실 줄 믿습니다.
God, we believe you will give us new strength today.
불신자가 보고 하나님을 알 수 있도록 축복해 주옵소서.
And may you bless us all so that people may be able to see that God is with us.
여호와가 목자 되심을 고백하는 증거를 주시옵소서.
Give us the evidence so that we can testify that the Lord is our shepherd and we lack nothing.
여호와의 신이 함께 하시는 능력을 체험하게 해 주옵소서.
May we experience the power of God that was with David.
하나님의 백성들이 가는 곳에 악신이 물러가게 해 주시옵소서.
And in every place where the people of God go, May evil spirits depart. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.